Hello, guys. Here we have a DStv Explorer. Anyway, I want to show you something that also surprised me. This is a DStv Explorer, and we know what a DStv Explorer decoder does, right? I want you to watch this video to see what shocked me. Let's go ahead. Let's see. Alright, so you prepare your screwdriver and then you flip the DStv over to remove all the screws around your decoder. Anyway, keep in mind, this was given to me by a friend, so he bought it by 100 rand, meaning it was more like given to him like free of charge, compared to the actual value of the a working decoder. But anyway, I believe this is faulty. This was faulty. I'm not sure, because I didn't check this decoder. Why? I was surprised that there is a hard drive inside. So my friend was aware that inside those DStv Explorers there is a big hard drive. A big hard drive that you can use as an additional external storage. I was also surprised, you'll see the size, because I was also shocked by the size. So what you do to remove a hard drive on this, you have to remove the screws, four screws aside on both sides. You have to unscrew those screws. So what I did was I flipped the decoder all over and then I unscrew both screws on the left hand side, and then after that, so once I was done, I moved on to another side. So I did the same thing as well. I removed the screws. I tried anyway here, but anyway it was too hard until I realized that there was a screw aside. I want you to see the size. This is a 2 terabyte 2000 gig Western Digital hard drive. I was so surprised. Anyway, after removing the hard drive, shocked that even this board as well, they used almost the same chips as the laptop. They used almost the same components. You will find what? You will find a SATA cable, a power SATA cable, and you'll find a data SATA cable as well. But after that, you will see some components that they are using here. And I noticed the memories, the DStv has those memories and a memory chip there. And they have the MOSFETs. Capacitors, you'll see coils, you'll see ceramic capacitors, you'll see diode, you'll see transistors, resistors, all the components that we deal with on laptops, you'll find them here. They're all here, guys. I was surprised, including the CPU as well, but it's a special CPU for processing all the information. So in case if you have a dead decoder with no power or some power issues, maybe it turns on or shut down, all those things, this is what you need to check. You need to check those electrolytic capacitor, and there is a power check right there near the USB port. So make sure you check the DC inject. You move on, check the capacitors, those electrolytic capacitors, and then that's it, guys. Anyway, I'm gonna see you on my next video. Don't forget to press the subscribe button. I love you so much.